Hi, in this tutorial we will learn how to add multiple materials to the same mesh. Also, after that we will add a texture map to each of these materials, and we will see how we can add multiple UVW maps modifiers and force each one of them, each one of these UVW maps, to control the mapping of specific texture. So first I will create a plane. Press F4 to see the wireframe of the object. Press G to hide the grid. I will reduce the number of polygons to 3. Convert to editable poly. Go to polygon, and here if I select this face, you'll see that it has a material ID of 1, also this one, and also this one. Now I will click on this one and make the material ID 2, and here I will make it 3. Now open the material editor by pressing M on the keyboard. Here it doesn't matter what kind of material you're using. I'm using V-Ray, so it's a V-Ray material, but it works for all kind of materials. Click the name of the material and go to General and double click the multi sub-object. I will choose to keep this as part of the multi sub-object material. The multi sub-object material, basically it's not a material by itself. It's a container of materials. So here by default we have these. I don't need the 10 of them. You can keep them, but I will set the number to 3. So I will assign this multi sub object material to this object. Now you can see the blue, this first material. It's shown on the first polygon because this material has an ID of 1, as you can see here, and this is 1. These are black because I didn't assign any material yet, so I'll click this one. And I will choose V-Ray material. I'll make it pink. So now I have 3 materials assigned to the same mesh. Now if I choose this one and make it 1, for example, here, you can see that now both of them are blue. I will bring it back to 2. Now, for each material, instead of a color, I will assign a texture map here. So I will click this button here, go to General Bitmap. I will choose this image here, click Show Shaded Material in Viewport to see it. For the second one, I will choose another bitmap. Now, if I add a UVW map to this object, here I created the shortcuts for the modifiers, but typically you will go to this list here. And choose the UVW map. Now, if I select the gizmo and start to play around with the mapping, you can see that this UVW map is affecting the three textures. The reason is that if you look here, you will see that this UVW map is affecting the map channel 1. Now, if you go to the bitmap level in each material, you can see that the map channel by default is one. Same here. And same here. So this one I will make it 3. This one I will make it 2, and I will keep the first one. Now, when I move around, you can see that I'm affecting this texture here. Now I can add another UVW map. Okay, by default it's 1, of course, as usual. I will make it 2. Now, if I select the gizmo of this one, I'm affecting the second one only. And this one, now I can add a third one. And for this one, I will choose number 3. And this UVW map is controlling this bitmap texture. If I change this to 2, this will control this bitmap, and it will override this one that is controlling the second one. Now it is controlled by this one. Of course, unless you turn off this button here, so now this button here will give you the result of all the modifiers in the stack, starting from down up. I will bring it back to 3. So that's it for this tutorial. Hope you like it. And if you do, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you in the next tutorial. Thank you.